Today, we're going to walk through the MIPS data submission process. We'll review the three MIPS reporting options, how to upload a file, how to review previously submitted data, and how to delete data. At this point, I've signed into the QPP website. We'll click Start Reporting from the homepage. When you log in, you'll see the different organizations you have permission to access. If you have permission for different organization types like I do, you'll see these separated by tabs on the page. For today's video, we'll look at the bonus practice. We can see this practice is MIPS eligible and has clinicians associated with an APM. As a representative of the bonus practice, I have the option to report as a group, as a subgroup, or for individuals within the practice. I have the option for a subgroup because the practice's security official completed a MIPS value pathway registration for subgroup reporting before the submission period. You can't report a MIPS value pathway or MVP if you didn't register before the submission period. We'll start by clicking Report as Individuals. From here, I can still report as a group, or I can select the individual clinician or clinicians for whom I want to report data or review previously submitted data. For purposes of this video, we'll select Report as a Group. This group has three reporting options. The first is the APM Performance Pathway, or APP. This option is displayed because the practice includes clinicians in a MIPS APM. Only clinicians that participate in a MIPS APM are eligible for a final score from APP reporting. The second is traditional MIPS. This is the original reporting option that allows clinicians and groups to select from all available quality measures and improvement activities. The third option is an MVP. For each available reporting option, you'll see the ability to start reporting or edit submission. You'll see start reporting when no data has been submitted, or edit submission when some data has already been reported. Today, I want to upload a file for my group's traditional MIPS reporting. I'll click Start Reporting next to Traditional MIPS. Then I see the ability to upload a file. I'll browse to attach my file and click Upload File. You can see I received an error message and the option to download an error report. If you don't understand why your file wasn't accepted, contact the service center using the contact information on the modal. After fixing my file, I'll upload it again. This time, I see a success message. I'll click View Submission. The file I uploaded had data for quality, promoting interoperability, and improvement activities. So my last step will be to review the data that I submitted for each performance category. Please make sure you check all data that's been reported by or on behalf of your practice before the March 31st submission deadline, and contact the service center if you have questions. Once the submission period ends, you can't submit or correct previously submitted data. I see on my reporting summary card that tells me when data was first submitted and provides me with a submission ID. If you need to contact the service center about your submission, you'll need to provide this ID. For today's video, we'll review my quality submission, but in real life, I'd repeat this for each performance category. To review my quality submission, I'll click View and Edit on the quality card. From the quality page, I see the measures that count towards my score. I can open the measure card and view the scoring and reporting details for each measure. I'll check that all measures I submitted are reflected on the page. I submitted 7 measures for traditional MIPS when only 6 are required, so I see 6 measures that count and 1 measure that doesn't count. The 7th measure is my lowest scoring measure. Please note that administrative claims measures and the CAPS for MIPS survey measure aren't available during the submission period. These will be added when we release final scores in June. In addition to reviewing your measures, you can visit the QPP website to learn more about quality requirements for traditional MIPS. You can download the data submission guide for traditional MIPS. You can print your quality measure submission information and delete data. If you need to delete data that your practice has uploaded, I click Manage Data. From here, I have the ability to delete data that was submitted by our practice. I don't have the ability to delete data that was submitted on our behalf by a third party. When I delete my data, I see that reflected immediately on the screen. When I click Group Reporting Overview, I'll return to the traditional MIPS reporting overview page. The quality measure card now indicates that I haven't started reporting. Thank you for watching today's video. For more information on data submission, go to the QPP Resource Library and enter submission as your search term.